cellular protozoal cell have metabolic process closer to the those of human host than to prokaryotic bacterial pathogens. Protozoal diseases are thus less easily treated than bacterial infections, and many of the antiprotozoal drugs cause serious toxic effect in the host, particularly on cell showing high metabolic activity such as neuronal, renotubular, intestinal and bone marrow stem cells. Some antiprotozoal drugs like amebiasis, for example chloroquine, dihydroamethane, emetine, iodoquinone, metronidazole, paramomycin and tinidazole. The second one, disease malaria, and the drugs are artemisinin, chloroquine, mefloquine, primaquine, pyrimethamine, quinine and quinidine. Next one is trypanosomiasis. Drugs are benzinidazole, melarsoprol, nifurtimox, pentamidine and suramin. Next one is leishmaniasis. The drug are sodium acetylgluconate. The next one is toxoplasmosis. The drug are pyrimethamine. And the last one is giardiasis. The drugs are metronidazole, nitazolinide and tinidazole. Anti-malarial medications. Anti-malarial are designed to prevent or cure malaria. Such drug may be used for some or all of the following treatment of malaria in individual with suspected or confirmed infection. Prevention of infection in individual visiting a malaria endemic region who have no immunity, malaria prophylaxis. Routine intermittent treatment of certain groups in endemic region, intermittent preventive therapy. Anti-malarial drug resistance has been defined as the ability of a parasite to survive and or multiply despite the administration and absorption of a drug given in dose equal to or higher than those usually recommended but within tolerance of the subject. The drug in question must gain access to the parasite or the infected red blood cells for the duration of the time necessary for its normal action. In most instances, this refers to parasite that remaining following on form and observed treatment. Thus, excluding all cases where antimalarial prophylaxis has failed in order for a case to be defined as resistant, the patient under question must have received a known and observed antimalarial therapy. Whilst the blood, drug and metabolites concentration are monitored concurrently. Drugs for trypanosomiasis or trypanosomosis we have already discussed in module 6. Drugs for leishmaniasis. There are no consistently recommended medications for giardiasis in pregnancy because of the potential for adverse drug effect of the baby. If your symptoms are mild, your doctor may recommend delaying treatment until after the first trimester. If treatment is necessary, discuss the best available treatment options with your doctor. Treatment is tailored to the individual because leishmaniasis is caused by many species or subspecies of leishmania. Pharmacological therapies include the following: pentavalent antimony, sodium acetylgluconate or meglumin antimonate used in cutaneous leishmaniasis, not marketed in the United States but available through the CDC under an investigations new drug IND protocol. Liposomal Amphotericin B, effective against pentavalent antimony resistance, mucocutaneous disease and visceral leishmaniasis. Oral miltefosine, approved by the FDA in March 2014 for visceral leishmaniasis due to L. donovani, cutaneous leishmaniasis due to L. brasiliensis, L. guaianensis and L. panamensis, and mucosal leishmaniasis due to L. brasiliensis. Intramuscular pentamidine, effective against visceral leishmaniasis but associated with persistent diabetes mellitus and disease recurrence. Orally administered ketoconazole, itraconazole, fluconazole, allopurinol and dapsone. None is as effective as the pentavalent antimony compound, but they may be useful in accelerating curve in patient with cutaneous leishmaniasis that does not progress to mucosal disease and tend to self-resolve. Topical paromomycin shown to be effective against cutaneous leishmaniasis caused by L. miser and L. mexicana, etc. Sitamycin, undergoing phase 3 trials, drug for giardiasis. When signs and symptoms are several or the infection persists, doctor usually treat giardiasis with medications such as metronidazole. Metronidazole is a most commonly used antibiotic for giardia infection. Side effects may include nausea and a metallic taste in the mouth. Don't drink alcohol while taking this medication. Next, tinidazole. Tinidazole works as well as metronidazole, has many of the same side effects, but it can be given in a single dose. Nitazoxanide. Because it is common in a liquid form, nitazoxanide may be easier for children to swallow. Side effects may include nausea, flatulence, yellow eyes and brightly colored yellow urine. Module 8, Summary and Conclusion. Amoebic colitis is caused by the parasitic anti-amoeba Estrelytica. This protozoan is disturbed throughout the world and is commonly acquired by ingestion of contaminated food or water. It is estimated that about 40 to 50 million people infected with E. Estrelytica develop amoebic colitis or extra-intestinal abscesses, which result in up to 1 lakh death per year. Metronidazole is currently the drug of choice for treating invasive amoebiasis in adults and children, but it may not be sufficient to eliminate parasite cyst in the intestine. Combination with other drugs are therefore also used. However, the evidence to support combination thereby has not been reviewed. Also, some unpleasant adverse effect associated with metronidazole in some patients, and the possibility of parasite resistance to metronidazole has to be considered. This script compares different drugs used against amoebic colitis alone or in combination, and also assesses single dose regimen versus longer regimen. The author concludes that tinidazole appears more effective at reducing clinical failure than metronidazole and has fewer associated adverse events. There is insufficient evidence to draw conclusion regarding the efficacy of the other anti-amoebic drugs. However, the trials methodologically quality was generally inadequate. Also, the choice of antiamoebic drug would depend largely on the availability and accessibility of the drugs. So, dear student, this is Dr. Varsha Kashyap. Take leave from you with the hope that you enjoyed and understood today's lecture. We will continue in our next lecture with another topic. If you want to learn more and enhance your knowledge, you may log on our website for detail, and the website is www.cec.nic.in. Till then.